Good morning, everyone. Praise the Lord. What a glorious day. Amen.
Amen.
I welcome you this morning to this feast of service. On behalf of the pastor, we welcome you. May everyone be blessed, and may something out this service touch you and fill you, that you go leave here different from what you came this morning. Amen.
Amen.
Let us clear our hearts and minds and receive the Holy Spirit. Lord God, you love the world so much that you gave your one and only begotten Son. And whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Lord, help us to live in the gladness and grace of Easter Sunday every day. Let us have hearts of thankfulness for your sacrifice. It was through the blood of Jesus our sins has been washed away. Let us have eyes that look upon your grace and rejoice in our salvation. Help us to walk in the mighty grace and tell your good news to the world. Lord, we just ask you to just continue to bless this morning worship service. Send your anointing. Fill each heart with your Holy Spirit. Bless our pastor as you deliver our sacred word, and may it touch someone. We praise you. We glorify you. We worship you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Amen.
We will now have a selection from the choir. Amen. Amen.
Good morning.
Good morning.
This is the day that the Lord has made. Amen.
Amen.
We just give the Lord a hand clap of praise even this morning.
Yes.
Hallelujah. For he is risen as he said. We want to open up with the song, Lord, I Lift Your Name on High. It says, Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I love to sing your praises. I'm so glad you're in my life. I'm so glad you came to save us. You came from heaven to earth to show the way, from the earth to the cross, my debt to pay, from the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky, Lord, I lift your name on high. Amen?
Amen.
Amen.
Lord, I
lift. Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I love to sing your praises. I'm so glad you're in my life. I'm so glad you came to save us. You came from heaven to earth to show the way, from the earth to the cross, my debt to pay, from the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky. Lord, I lift your name on high.
Lord, I lift.
Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I love to sing your praises. I'm so glad you're in my life. I'm so glad you came to save us.
You came
from heaven to earth to show the way, from the earth to the cross, my debt to pay, from the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky.
Lord, I lift your name on high.
You came from heaven to earth to show the way, from the earth to the cross, my debt to pay, from the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky.
Lord, I lift your name on high.
One more time. You came, and
you came from heaven to earth to show the way, from the earth cross, my debt to pay. From the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky,
Lord, I lift your name on high.
Amen.
Develop and maintain the capacity to forgive. He who is devoid of the power to forgive is devoid of the power to love. There is some good in the worst of us and some evil in the best of us. When we discover this, we are less prone to hate our enemies.
Amen. We now have a selection. I'm sorry. We now have scripture reading by Brother Ricks.
And when the Sabbath was passed, Mary Magdalene and Mary the mother of James and Solomon had bought sweet spices, that they might come and anoint him. And very early in the morning, the first day of the week, they went unto the sepulchre at the rising of the sun. And they said among themselves, who shall roll us away the stone from the door of the sepulchre? And when they looked, they saw that the stone was rolled away, for it was very great. And entering into the sepulchre, they saw a young man sitting on the right side, clothed in a long white garment. And they were affrighted. And he saith unto them, be not affrighted. Ye see Jesus of Nazareth, which was crucified. He is risen. He is not here. Behold, the place where they laid him. But go your way, tell his disciples and Peter that he goeth before you into Galilee. There shall he see him as he said unto you. And they went out quickly and fled from the sepulchre, for they trembled and were amazed. Neither said they anything to any man, for they were afraid. The reading of the scripture, praise be to God.
Amen.
Amen.
We will now have another selection from the choir, and then we will hear from our pastor.
Yeah, and our second selection is old classic familiar hymn, There is Power in the Blood. And so by all means, I know we have some sopranos and altos and tenors out there. Feel free to join in. Amen. Verse 1, would you be free from the burden of sin? There's power in the blood, power in the blood. Would you over evil a victory win? There's wonderful power in the blood. One, two, three, two.
Would you be free from the burden of sin? It's high in the blood, it's high in the blood. Would you love me, all of victory when there's power in the blood? Power, wonder working power in the blood. the precious blood of the Lamb.
Verse 2.
Would you be free from the passionate pride? It's found in the blood, found in the blood. Come for your cleansing to Calvary's cross. There's wonderful power in the blood. There is power, power, wonder working out in the blood of the Lamb. There is power, power, wonder working out in the precious blood of the Lamb.
Verse 3, would you be whiter?
Would you be whiter, much whiter than snow? There's power in the blood, power in the blood. Sin's stains are lost in his life-giving flow. There's wonderful power in the blood. There is power, power, wonder-working power in the blood. Precious blood of the Lamb.
Would you do service?
Would you do service for Jesus our King? There's power in the blood, power in the blood. Would you live daily His praises to sing? There's wonderful power in the blood. There is power, power, wonder-working power in the blood of the Lamb. There is power, power, wonder-working power in the precious blood of the Lamb.
There is power.
There is power, power, wonder-working power in the blood.
Christ is risen.
Amen. Amen.
Hey, when I say Christ is risen, you're supposed to say Christ is risen indeed.
Yes,
Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed.
Oh, hallelujah. Amen. Yeah. I'm so glad to be alive on this morning and able to have breath in my body and activity in my limbs. I'm thankful to God. God is good this morning. Amen. 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 This is the day that the Lord has made. We can rejoice even at this early hour. You early risers are blessed this morning because you got up with the sunrise as Jesus got up. Amen?
Amen.
Well, this morning we are, of course, looking at a classic scripture from Mark chapter 16. And it made me think about our human bodies this morning. So, in caring for these human bodies that we have, right, there's different levels that we do. Sometimes some of us do a lot of prevention to keep our bodies healthy, right? We do our exercise, we eat right, we try not to do, you know, unhealthy things like smoking or drinking or doing things like that. So there's prevention that we do. There's also things you can do to keep your body healthy, like taking vaccine, right? Vaccine to keep away some of the, you know, some of the diseases that are out there. We know about that, right? There's treatments too. You can have a radiation treatment if you have something go wrong, like a cancer. You can have medication that you take for different things. You can have surgery to correct different problems, things like that, right? And then there's cures. Cures get your body back to where it was. I want to talk today about something that's even better than a cure, the resurrection of the body. Amen.
Amen.
So that's the title of this message, Resurrection, Better Than a Cure.
Yes.
Let us pray. Almighty God, you are awesome, and you have awakened us this morning, just like you woke up Jesus that morning thousands and thousands of years ago. We thank you for his precious blood, the wondrous working blood. We thank you that he rose up with all power in his hands. And so now, oh God, as I proclaim these words, I pray that you remove me from myself, Lord, that we might hear from you. And may these words out of my mouth and the meditation on all these hearts gathered be acceptable to you, God, our strength, our Redeemer. Amen. Amen. So we're in a fight with death, y'all. All our lives long, it's kind of an uphill battle with death. And when you look at this year that we have just had, it feels like death is winning, doesn't it? Mm-hmm. I mean, this has been some kind of a year. Over 2.8 million people have died from the coronavirus this year, worldwide. And now we're in a race to get the vaccine, to get humanity vaccinated against these variants. I don't know about you, but I personally have lost two first cousins to this virus, and I've prayed with many other friends and family, and we have cried together about their loved ones, and I've seen countless posts on my Facebook, social media of people just mourning their friends who are gone too suddenly and gone too soon, right? And so it's been a bear of a year. Death seems to be overshadowing everything this year. But now we have this vaccine rolling out, right? And it seems to give us a little bit of hope. We have a little bit of hope here with this vaccine. It feels a little bit like spring with this vaccine coming on, right? One day we might be able to eat together again, and one day we might be able to visit each other again in person. One day we might be able to not wear masks together again in person. And so it feels like hope is springing. But what I found interesting about this new hope that we have in this vaccine is that these vaccines are pretty lame, y'all. They're pretty lame. Did you know that they don't actually prevent you from getting COVID-19? No, they just prevent you, should you get it, from getting really bad symptoms. Or in most cases, they prevent you from dying from these symptoms, right? And so I'm just amazed that something with so little power can give us so much hope, right? I say so little power because after I got my vaccine, I was blessed to get my vaccine about a month ago, so I feel fully protected now. But after I got my shot, it was a one shot, it was a Johnson & Johnson one shot and done. After I got my shot, I was feeling so hopeful and happy. But then, you know, after a little while, I thought, you know what? Something else could get me. I could get cancer, I could get diabetes, something could happen to me. Some crazy person could come out with a gun and just shoot me for no reason at all. And it just, you know, it kind of reminded me that eventually something's gonna get me and take me out of here, even if it's old age. And I hope it's old age, amen? Okay. That's what I'm hoping for. I'm equally amazed that we have something so much more powerful than these vaccines. Jesus has not just given us a cure for death, but he's given us more than a cure. Oh, the resurrection is the most powerful weapon against death, and yet there's so many people who refuse it. So the women in our text today that we heard read there, Brother Vernon, from Mark chapter 16:1, it says, when the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of James, and Salome brought spices so they could go and anoint Jesus' dead body. See that the women went there, they went there to deal with death, Pam. They were there to do the rituals of death, acknowledging that death had won again. And so I imagine as they came to a place of the dead, similar to this place, they probably had heaviness on their heart. They probably felt the pall of death on their hearts, right? Just like we've been feeling it this year. And little did they know that they were gonna encounter something even more powerful than death, the resurrection. The resurrection is better than a cure. So we don't have a cure for COVID-19, but we have these vaccines. And if you remember last, some of you were on last week on the Zoom. Last week we were doing a little survey. We said, we were asking how, you know, where people were in terms of their vaccination. We said, are you not interested in the vaccine? Or are you maybe not eligible for the vaccine? Because last week, everything changed. Last week, you had to be a certain age or in a certain category to be eligible. So maybe you were not eligible. Some people had one shot, but they were waiting on the second one, right? Mm-hmm. And some people are fully vaccinated. So we asked last week, and only a small percentage said that they were not interested at all in this vaccination. Maybe they're suspicious of vaccines, which I can understand. Maybe they say, well, I'm young and healthy, so I'm not interested in this vaccine. Maybe they said, I'm in Christ. I feel safe. I don't mind if I die. I don't really care. I don't know what the reason was, but for some reason, some people said they were not interested in this vaccine. Some of our people surveyed said they were not eligible for the vaccine yet, and some people had their first shot, waiting on the second one. But the biggest percentage, oh hallelujah, were those who were fully vaccinated. They were all done. And so I began to wonder, after we took that little survey, I began to wonder, what would it be like if we took a survey about the resurrection? You know, if we said, who's interested in this resurrection as a cure for death? Would people say, A, not interested? Would some people say, I'm not eligible? Would some people say, well, I'm kind of there. I'm starting to believe, but not yet. And with some people to say, I'm fully believing. I'm fully vested in this resurrection. Well, I suspect if we did this survey, like not in the church, but out in the world, right, in America today, we might get a high percentage of people saying, I'm not interested. We might get a high percentage of people saying, you know what, I'm not interested. Because in our society today, so many people are not interested in what the church has to say. They just refuse to believe in the resurrection. I think there's a number of reasons. Let's just delve into these for one moment. I think there's a number of reasons why many people in the world today might say, I'm not interested in this resurrection. Well, I think the first one is, we as human beings, you know, we cannot control the resurrection. Can we? I mean, it's not like you can go to the Mass Res site and make your appointment, right? You can't go on there and say, well, you know, I think after about 5 years, I'm going to have my resurrection. We don't have any control over this, right? We know in the church, we say there's going to be a great getting up morning where everybody's going to get up out of these graves. All the people in here, they're going to get up out of their graves. We're going to get up out of their graves. But we don't know when it is. And we don't have control over when it is. And so I think a lot of people, they just will say not interested because they don't have any control over this thing. It's all about God. It's about when God says it's going to be. Some people might check not interested because they don't like the church. Oh, I'm talking about the church with a big capital C. The church. Because the church has become a religious establishment. The church is no longer that edgy, ragtag band of rebels that followed around Jesus Christ, who himself was a rebel. We've lost that kind of edginess. The church, with a big capital C, has become the establishment, right? And the church, now don't get me wrong, the church throughout history has done a lot of good things. A lot of good things for people, a lot of things for people. But the church, with a capital C, has also done some very terrible things. I'm just going to put it out there. The church has done a lot of things that are oppressive, that are racist, that are sexist, that are homophobic, that are all these different things. The church has done all of these things all throughout history. And so some people know that the church has used aggressive force to cause death as opposed to resurrection. And they say, no, I'm not going to believe because that church, I know the church has done some bad things, and they just said not interested. Another reason I think people might check not interested is because they just doubt that the story is true. They say, you Christians, you keep saying he's coming back soon, but it's been 2021 years, right? Yeah. We haven't seen him yet. Not in person. So some people have started to say, I think this is just a fairy tale, I don't know. And so that's why I think a high percentage of people would check maybe not interested if we did a survey like that. I wonder how many people would say, not eligible. They would believe themselves to be not eligible for this cure for death, the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Because they say all those people, Christians, they don't look like me. They don't talk like me. They don't act like me. And so I could never be one of those people. It makes me sad to think that there would be a large number of people who would feel unwelcome. They feel like this is not for me. It makes me sad because, you know what? That is just not true. Because Jesus welcomes everybody. He says, whosoever will, let them come. God loved the whole world, the whole wide world so much that he gave his only begotten son. And so it makes me sad that some people would think that they were just not eligible for this resurrection cure. And there are also many people who are so close. They go to church. They have a conscience. They have a moral conscience, right? They serve, they give, but yet they hadn't got to that second shot yet because they haven't really believed in Christ's resurrection for real. Friends, I have a special place in my heart for these people. I call them the one shot away folk because that's where I was for such a long time in the church. I was somebody who went to church. I gave at church. I served on committees at church. I did a lot of things. But I had never talked to Jesus for my own self. And in the Bible, Romans 10 and 9, it says that if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, that's when you'll be saved. That's what it says in the Bible. So I'm so thankful that God brought me to that second shot. God brought me to that fourth group of people who say, yes, they would check, yes, I am fully vested in this cure, in this resurrection power. Oh, hallelujah. I'm glad for that number. And this group, if you're in that number, we have a great obligation to our neighbors. You know, some people say, oh, I don't need to get vaccinated because I'm young, I'm healthy, whatever. But what about your neighbor? Don't you care enough about your neighbor to keep them safe? So everybody's in this fourth group, fully vested, fully knowing that when you die, you're going to go with Christ, right? This fourth group, we have a great obligation to our neighbors. We have an obligation to love our neighbors. When they have control issues, where they say, I can't control this thing, we have to encourage them to just surrender all and say, I surrender all to Christ. We have to encourage them. Where they've been offended by the church and hurt by the church, that's where we bring the healing. We bring the love. When they don't believe that Jesus could love a wretch like them, we tell them, well, guess what? He can, because you know why? He loved a wretch like me. That's how I know. When they have doubts, when they have questions, when they have concerns, when they have criticisms, we just have to be patient and witness in faith, right? Because we're all gonna have to deal with death at some point. So that's why I'm thankful for this higher hope that we have, that Jesus gives us beyond death. And so let's just look at our scripture a little bit more in Mark chapter 16. When he goes down to the sixth verse, there was a messenger there in the tomb. And the messenger said, don't be alarmed. You are looking for Jesus of Nazareth who was crucified, but he has been raised. He is not here. Hallelujah. In other words, the messenger was telling them that Jesus had been resurrected. Jesus, friends, has given us the cure for death, something even better than a cure. The resurrection is like the undeath. Some of you remember that old commercial where 7-Up was like the un-cola. The resurrection is the undeath. It makes you undead. It undoes the death, right? Resurrection is better than prevention because it's not really prevention. If we just have prevention, God would let us live on in these bodies that we're in. But these bodies are in a sinful state. We're in a sad state, so God doesn't want that. It's not just prevention. It's better than a vaccine because vaccines are weak. As we just saw, you can still get symptoms. You can still get sick. You can still die. But the resurrection is perfectly powerful. Yeah. The resurrection is better than treatment. is better than medicines that you have to keep taking over and over and over. Because Jesus Christ, when he died and he hung on the cross, he paid for sin once for all, for the whole eternity. He did the whole thing. It's better than a treatment. It's better than prevention. It's better than vaccine. It's better than treatment. And finally, I want to say, the resurrection is even better than a cure. When I started writing this message, Jack, I said, resurrection, the cure for death. Then the Holy Spirit said, no, Selena. It's better than a cure. It's better than a cure. God's Spirit and power, he said, no, Jesus didn't just cure death, he outdid death.
Yes, he did.
When he rose up, he didn't rise up in that same old human body he had before. Jesus rose up in his glorified body, y'all. In his glorified body, first of all, he wasn't dead anymore, right? He was breathing again. He was alive. He lives today. Oh, hallelujah. But it didn't stop there, y'all. Jesus' glorified body was far better than the one he had before.
Amen.
The medical cures, you know, cures, they aim to get you back to the state of health that you had before, right? But they don't get you back to better than you were before, Caleb. Jesus' glorified body did supernatural things. I know Jesus in his original incarnation, he did miracles, right? But he did what the Father told him to do. He did it by the power of the Holy Spirit. That's what he did. But Jesus in his previous physical body, he had to be limited by human limitations just like us. Jesus had to come through the birth canal just like us.
Yes.
He had to be a tiny little baby just like us. He had to learn how to walk and how to talk just like us. And he had to walk from place to place. He had to ride on a donkey from here to there just like we do in that original body. But when Jesus rose up on that day, he rose up in his glorified body, y'all. So we look at verse 3 of our text in Mark chapter 16. When the women were on their way to the tomb, it says, they were saying to each other, who is going to roll the stone away from the entrance for us? When they looked up, they saw that the stone had been rolled away. And then it says something interesting in parentheses there. It says, and it was a very large stone. Yes, it was. Jesus, in his glorified body, got up and he just rolled the stone away like Superman. Oh, hallelujah. The new body was better than the previous one because he was better than he was before. He was like the bionic man, y'all. Some of y'all remember the bionic man. He was better. He was faster. He was stronger than before. He was better than the bionic man. If you read in the Bible, you find that Jesus could appear and disappear, right? He could float up into heaven if he wanted to, right? Into another realm, if you will. And you know, we have great imaginations in our sci-fi community these days because in sci-fi, they like to imagine that people can travel from place to place. And they can be transported from here to there. And you're like, okay, beam me up, Scotty, and then you're over there, right? And we have things that are in different realms. There's this realm and that realm. It's all very fascinating. But Jesus was able to do all those things in his glorified body, right? He was able to appear here and there. I mean, he was still physical because he touched people, he ate with people, but then he was gone like poof, right? And then he ascended into heaven. Wow. If you thought the newness and the excitement of being free from coronavirus was exciting, it doesn't have nothing on the resurrection of Jesus Christ in the body, right? Jesus was the first one to do it. He was the first fruits. And therefore, we can have hope that we will follow after him. In 1 Corinthians 15, it says, but in fact, Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. So that means because Jesus was resurrected in his glorified body, we will also be resurrected in our glorified bodies. We'll be able to do things that we were not able to do in these regular old bodies, right? Eternal life is going to be amazing, y'all. It's going to be amazing. The resurrection is going to be beyond our wildest imaginations. Eyes have not seen, ears have not heard. It has not entered into the imaginations of human beings. Not even our greatest sci-fi writers can imagine the creativity of our God, what God has prepared for us. Eyes have not seen, ears have not heard. It has not entered into our imaginations what God has prepared for those who love God. And so I'm so excited to be able to check that fourth box and say, I am fully vested in this resurrection. I'm glad that I am able, by the grace of God, to check that box because guess what? Resurrection is better than a cure. Amen? Amen. 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 you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. And so I would like to ask, if you were here, and you might be in that group that says, no, I'm not interested. I'm going to change your mind today. Or if you're in that group that says, I don't think I'm really eligible for this. That's for those Christians over there. That's not me. Jesus loves us all of humanity, everybody. No matter where you've been, what you've done, who you are, what color you are, old, young, whatever, it doesn't matter. Jesus is for everybody. You're eligible. Or if you're here and you say, well, I go to church, I do these things, I feel like I'm doing everything that everybody else is doing, but when they talk about this resurrection, I don't believe it yet. You can pray today and say, Jesus, I believe it. And go into that fourth category. So if there's anybody here today and you like to pray, you just say, Christ, I believe you, that you rose up. You can come up and you can pray. Anybody want to pray today and just say, right here on this beautiful resurrection day, this glorious place. So the bold ones are for you to respond. Christ our Lord invites to his table all who love him, who earnestly repent of their sin, and seek to live in peace with one another. Therefore, let us confess our sin before God and one another. Together, merciful God, we confess that we have not loved you with our whole heart. We have failed to be an obedient church. We have not done your will. We have broken your law. We have rebelled against your love. We have not loved our neighbors. And we have not heard of our enemy. Forgive us, we pray. Free us from all of our worries. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Hear the good news. Christ died for us while we were yet sinners. That proves God's love toward us. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven.
In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven.
Glory to God. Amen. Let's now repeat our affirmation of faith together. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of the saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. You formed us in your image and breathed into us the breath of life. We turned away and our love failed. When we turned away and our love failed, your love remained steadfast. You delivered us from captivity, made covenant to be our sovereign God, brought us to a land flowing with milk and honey, and set before us the way of life. And so, with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Holy are you and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ. By the baptism of his suffering, death, resurrection, you gave birth to your church, delivered us from slavery to sin and death, and made with us a new covenant by water and the Spirit. By your great mercy, we have been born anew to a living hope through the resurrection of your Son from the dead, and to an inheritance that is imperishable, undefiled, and unfading. Once we were no people, but now we are your people, declaring your wonderful deeds in Christ, who called us out of darkness into his marvelous light. When the Lord Jesus ascended, he promised to be with us always in the power of your word and Holy Spirit. On the night in which he gave himself up for us, he took the cup, gave thanks to you, gave it to his disciples and said, drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. On the day you raised him from the dead, he was recognized by his disciples in the breaking of the bread and in the power of your Holy Spirit in your church, has continued in the breaking of the bread and in the sharing of this cup. And so in remembrance of these, your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with Christ's offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ is
dying.
Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Pour out your Holy Spirit on everybody gathered here and on these gifts of bread and wine. Make them be for us the body and the blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world until Christ comes in final victory and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit in your holy church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty God, now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
Let us now pray the prayer that Jesus taught his disciples, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us of our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen. So we're going to do give and go at this time because of coronavirus, right? If you need a gluten-free wafer, they are here. Just let me know. The elements have been blessed. May the power of God come into you as you take the body and the blood of Christ and go on your journey. Some other person that's going to distribute it, they'll be here as well. They are blessed. Thank you all for coming out this chilly morning. I hope your spirits and hearts have been warmed. Let's look to the Lord for a benediction. And now to the one who's able to keep us from falling, the one who's able to raise us from the dead, the one who's able to present us faultless before the throne, to the only wise God be both power, glory, dominion, and honor, now, henceforth, and forevermore. Let all the church say, amen. 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 Go and be blessed.
Amen.